5 months and one day after the last real Saturday night National Hockey League game in Ottawa, things looked completely different at Canadian Tire Centre. And we're not just talking about the tarped-off sections in the upper bowl. Way back on May 6, Kyle Turris scored at 6:28 of overtime to give the Senators an exciting 5-4 victory over the New York Rangers and a 3-2 series lead in the Eastern Conference semifinal. By comparison, the most recently completed Senators-Detroit Red Wings game was an absolute dud. There was one common denominator, however. If we're stretching it, 5 months and one day ago, Derick Brassard scored with 1:26 left in regulation to set up Turris's dramatics. Against the Red Wings, Brassard was initially credited with his second of the season, 1:51 from the third period buzzer, as the Senators again went into OT. 20 minutes after the Senators' 2-1 loss, credit for the goal was changed and given to Diane Phaneuf as replay officials decided after much examination that his shot had hit a Red Wing and not Brassard, before slipping by goalie Jimmy Howard. Brassard, who at least created some havoc on the equalizer, did have the last chance for Ottawa to walk away with a victory against Detroit, but he was stopped in the shootout for the second game in a row. Starts and stops, the goaltending of Howard and the Senators' Craig Anderson was very good in this one. Anderson made the most spectacular save when he dove across to grab an attempt at an open net by Justin Abdelkader in the second period, as the youngest player in Senators history, Alex Formanton anticipated feeling a little nervous prior to his NHL debut, but added, "After the first shift, I should be fine." While that first shift was uneventful, Formanton was guilty of a defensive zone giveaway on his next one. He didn't play again until he had three shifts in the second period. The anticipation skills of Mark Stone were evident during a first period penalty kill when he blocked a shot, lunged forward to knock a puck out of Senators' territory, and intercepted a pass in the neutral zone. Have we forgot to mention that the Senators have brought back Ice Girls to do the scraping during stops in play? Exactly 20 years ago to the day, the Senators beat the San Jose Sharks 1-0 on a goal by Sean McEachern and 23 saves by Damian Rhodes. Between periods, after leading the team with a plus 17 last season, Mike Hoffman started this one on the wrong foot with the minus 3 on Thursday. Over the course of a season, he said Saturday morning, the plus-minus stat was a pretty good thermometer of one's play. You never like to take a minus 3 in a game, Hoffman said. That kind of pisses you off, especially the first one. But I think there's nowhere to go but to improve from that stat. Might as well get that one out of the way early. Because they don't want it to be a story, the Senators don't announce attendance during a game like they used to do in the proud old days. Hence, you may not know that the count was 17,009, or 364 shy of a sellout, for Thursday's season opener. Rumblings are that includes the four tickets given to all team employees. There were more empty seats Saturday. I'm going to guess, because that's what we're left to do prior to receiving a sheet handed out 15 minutes after the buzzer, that about 16,000 turned out to see the Red Wings.